much, Carrier. You've done a wonderful job on this. Page 9, it says that confirming through a criminal background check if the deadly weapon is a firearm, that the respondent is legally eligible to own or possess firearms under state and federal law. Would this extreme risk preclude him from getting his weapons back because he's had this risk on it?
The answer is no. If you go back earlier in the text of the bill, you'll find that as soon as the court rules that he's no longer at risk, or it expires, and that's not renewed, that the sheriff of that county is then required to go back into Leeds through the state police and remove that temporary block for them to possess a firearm. So they could actually do, and of course, a transfer, because it's from a police agency, and we require police agencies elsewhere in the law to do a background check no matter who they're going to.
Follow-up question, if you don't mind.
Certainly, Gary, you have a question.
Certainly, Mr. Thank you very much. And so, for the record, what you're saying is that after the year, the record is expunged, and there'll be no record whatsoever.
At this point, if you read the bill the way it is, it's expunged out. This is a civil matter, you remember. This is a civil matter. This is not a criminal matter. The block that is placed into the firearms code for the background check is a civil matter. And we intentionally did this because, once again, as sitting on your desk, colleagues, Senator, there is a form there that outlines if you have been adjudicated by a court as being mental health in a criminal courtroom, you lose your right permanently. We've intentionally put language in here to prevent that from happening.
Thank you very much. And finally, to the bill.
To the ballot.
True freedom requires the rule of law and justice. And a judicial system in which the rights of some are not secured by the denial of rights to others. Very important statement.
Senator Burdick, you're closing.